Oh, it was definitely liberating. Like, my whole life up until sort of culling culture era, I was such a pushover. And I mean, up to a certain extent now, I still have those traits. I do let people take advantage and walk all over me. And I don't know why.
Big rubbish superpowers.
Yeah, yeah. This is what I mean. Like, I'm not like, oh, I just
they
like.
Rubbish, sorry, I'm just taking.
No, but it's cool. True. I'm not like, oh, I just, you know, go burn my enemies with laser beams out my eyes. I'm like, oh, I'll turn into a bed. Like, I'm so, I'm just so like a pushover at times. And yeah, for me, it was like a real, it sounds stupid, but it was a real revelation when it was like, I don't actually have to be friends with these people. Like, I don't actually have to have people in my lives that, my life that treat me like shit. I can tell them to fuck off. Mm. And when I realized that I could actually do that and that didn't make me a bad person, it just meant I was looking after myself. It was just like insane. So I finally, you know, I wasn't going around, you know, like punching people in the face and, you know, being an asshole, but I was just like, you know what? This friendship is over. I don't deserve to be treated like this and I'm done. And then I wrote a song about it and it was kind of like therapy. It was really good. It was great. It was me choosing to not be treated like shit anymore. And it was really cathartic. It was a really cool experience.
Yeah, I think it's very difficult to sort of pick the right people in life because it really shapes how you, we all know what a day with one person is like versus a day with another person, you know.
Yes.
It's a difficult thing to do, I think, is like finding the right people to be around, because it's what, whenever you hear anyone talking about success, it's always these kind of business types, which I sometimes envy a little, not envy, sometimes find a little bit annoying, but you know, they always say to cut the wrong people out, you know, make sure that you're kind of surrounding yourself with the right people. So yeah, it's I can kind of what's the word, sort of sympathize with that. Because it's not an easy, the other thing is it's not an easy thing to do either, because we'd all do it if it was.
Yeah, so, it's not easy at all. And what you realize, I think, when you do it is how small your circle actually is. Like I have the boys as my friends and one other friend and that's it. Like, and it's great because I trust them all with my life and I know that I'm never gonna, you know, get fucked over by any of those people, but it does make you realize you allow so many people to come into your life and dictate what you think and do and say. And we all just kind of, especially as like kids and teenagers, we kind of allow it to happen. But when you kind of get to adulthood, you don't need to put up with that shit anymore. Like, you're not in school, you're not in college, like you can just tell people to fuck off.
Yeah, that's I think it's, that's if anything, you can cut it short here and just be like, that's a good like summary of life lesson learned. Yeah. I'll just I'll suddenly see your box disappear from it. I'll be like, oh great.
Yeah. Well, I guess that was my mic drop.
Yeah. Was the process of you're talking about it being a bit of a sort of revelation, I guess. Is this sort of part if I ever ask any questions that you think like, oh, I don't want to talk about that, that's totally fine. I'm just
okay.
I think it's cool. I like to sort of ask about the things that shape people's lives, because I think that's what gives the most value to other people.
Yeah.
You know, listening.
Yeah.
When you're kind of cutting people out in that way, and it makes it sound really harsh, I just fucking people out, but like, was it something that happened quite immediately? You were like, I know these people, it sounds a bit almost mathematical, I know these people have got to go, but was it something that was quite instinctive that happened straight away, or was it a process that took you time to kind of figure out along the way?
Definitely a process, yeah. It wasn't like I woke up one day and I was like, right, you're all gone. Yeah. Like each song obviously is about a different person and those experiences like spanned across several years. So it was kind of me realizing I didn't have to have these people in my life. I keep saying lives. I'm like, I'm multiple people. So it was me realizing that and then kind of approaching the situation differently for each person. I mean, for example, like Hideous was about someone who I did immediately cut out. I was like, you know, these weren't people that were just like a bit annoying. These were people who did some serious damage to my family and me. And I was like, nope, you're gone. Like, bye. That's apps. That tie is completely severed. But then there's like other things that are a bit more complicated, family issues, things like that, where things have to be taken a bit slower and a bit more emotionally, I don't know, cautious, I suppose. So yeah, each event, I suppose, happened over different periods of time and with different approaches. But I think you can kind of hear that with the songs, you know, they're not all just like cutthroat. There are a couple in there that are a bit lighter and easier to listen to. So in a way, I suppose that kind of shows the approach for each person.
Yeah, I suppose the other thing is if they all got cut out in the same way, you'd end up with just the same song and then just paste a different name in each like in each chorus, just like fuck you exactly. blank, and then be like on that happy birthday. You've seen that happy birthday YouTube thing where they have a different, they have like every name under the sun, different.
No,
videos.
I haven't seen that. That sounds good.
You just end up with that with a different name in each one.
Like, yeah, exactly.
Yeah, sorry, that completely devalues the importance of what you were just saying. I did take that in. I promise.
No, it's all good.
But how so? What do you think, do you feel like you've sort of, how do you feel like you've sort of developed since that kind of, since sort of going through that process? Do you feel that you're sort of different now from that? Or
yeah, definitely. Like, to start with, it does feel like shit, because you go from being surrounded by people, even though they're toxic, to just being not alone, but you know, a significant amount of less people in your life. And you can have moments where you're like, oh fuck, maybe I should just kind of be friends with this person, because then I can go out and I can do this. And it's like, no, they're not bringing you anything positive, just keep, you know, keep within your circle. And yeah, so for a while it was a bit like daunting, because you do get used to being treated like shit by people, and you do get used to what's familiar. But after a while, when I realized, actually, I don't need these people in my life, self-esteem did definitely go up, and I was free to do things that I couldn't do before. And now I'm like, oh my God, why did I not get rid of them sooner? Like, I feel so much more confident. I feel so much more happy. I don't have to apologize for anything anymore. I can just be myself. And yeah, it's definitely been a journey. It's not just sort of like the second I let go of these people I was really happy. It's been sort of a journey of self-discovery, as cringe as that sounds.
It sounds cringy because a lot of people go through it, but it's cool that we have that people can share that experience in very different ways. So
yeah,
I wouldn't call it cringy.
Well, it's a process, isn't it? Like, it would be nice to say, yeah, I cut them out and then it was all rainbows and butterflies. But the reality is, when you cut people out of your life, you feel like shit for doing it. But after a while, you realize that it was the best possible thing you can do for yourself. And, you know, being selfish isn't always a bad thing. Sometimes it's the best thing you can do.
I don't think there's anything selfish about just doing what you need to do. Yeah, I think there are times when it can be where, you know, if you've promised something, or if someone rightfully has certain expectations of you, you know, they're dependent on you for in a good way, and then you sort of just drop them. That's a, you know, there are those responsibilities. But I think if it's purely a case of things like friendships, and it can be even family, you know, family. I think if there's no dependency in that sense, then sometimes, I wouldn't call it selfish just to do what you need to do. Because I think if we all, funnily enough, I think if we all acted that way, ironically, people, we'd have the room to grow as people and all be nicer to each other anyway. So
yeah, definitely.
Look at us figuring things out.